Afternoon, everyone. My name is Zhizhe Lin. My topic is synchronized control of robotic arm based on virtual reality and IMU sensing. I come from the National Taipei University of Technology. Okay, let's see the outline. Why we will introduce to the robotic arm based on the MR systems. Then I will describe the description, the system description, and the IMU based position orientation measurement and the VR models. Then I will discuss the integration of the offline and the online mode and make a brief conclusion. Okay, let's see the introduction. Jane Gios proposed a concept for human-robot interaction using techniques of VR on mobile devices like cell phones and tablets, like the HoloLens. Artemis proposed a nonlinear models prediction controls approach for real-time planning of point-to-point motions of serial robots that shares their workshop with humans. Alice presents the concepts and the architectures of a model prediction feedback controls system to be used for compensations communication delays in networks industry robots controls. Okay, let's see our system description. In our systems, there are four types. There are four systems. The first one is arm post capture device. There are three IMUs to capture the human's arms. Then we use this message to control the virtual integration models to check the motion and then use the synchronized controls to control the robot's arm. And the terminal program is Python. Here is our IO circuit self-developed arm post capture device. There are three IMU sensors based on here and here and here. And use the RF modules to transfer the capture the pulse to our system. The communications of proposed systems is based on MQTT communications architecture to integrates each device. The local computer is responsible for processing the hand postures and the positions returns by the IMU's device and transferred to the joint angles using the inverse kinematics. The value were connected using the MPC and the ARF algorithms. The data are then upload to the MQTT and the HoloLens subscribes the UR's joint angles. Then to check the positions, then we transfer to the real robots. Here is the IMU-based human's hand positions and orientation measurements. We use these two IMU to measure the robots. Here is the virtual reality models. We use these to capture the human's the position. Here is the human position. And the VR model is to check the realities, the implementations. In the circulants, we use trees. I'm used to fires the I square C to use Arduinos and then transfers by IF. And then the VR models, we can see the VR models will follow our hands the positions to check the correct. Then we transfer the motions to the actual models. The motion. Wait a minute. Okay, here you can see the motivation. We use the capture system to control the VR models. The VR model will transfer the positions to the actual models. Okay, you can see the model will follow in the rear arms position. Okay, here is the arms position, and here is the robust. The VR models, and here is the actual models. Okay. Okay. The object updates mode, the architecture, we use the D435 to capture the positions. Then we implement two experiment models, offline and online. In the offline models, trajectories, planes, and motion or smooth controls are achieved by curvating to enable the executions of the movements. In the online, a feedback control system will use to compensate for the disturbance and ensures the actual movement. Okay, here is the offline mode. We capture the user's arm to control the VR models. And then to check the correct kinetics. Okay, then the transfers the commands to the remodels. Okay, the next experiment is online mode architectures. Okay, you can see the robot will follows the virtual models. Here is the HoloLens. You can see HoloLens, the image. Okay, based on the improvements, we changed the tracking arrows based on the MPC control strategy. Okay, now I make a conclusion. VR integrated controls was implemented to test the system integration and the functions. Two control architectures was investigated in this study, offline and online. The offline mode used a curvetting methods for the trajectory planning and the implements of the VR models using the HoloLens 2 models to check the controls curve to achieve the predefined arms motions. The online mode considers the need for the remote controls and introduced APF controllers with feedback for trajectory planning and controls. This allows the real-time controllers to compensate for the robotic trajectory. And even if disturbance are encountered during the remote controls, it ensures the accuracy and the stability of the robot's motions. In summaries, the proposed controllers provide a reliable control strategy for remote control systems and offers an active, effective solution for achieving accuracy motions. Okay, thank you for your attention.
Collision with something from the pheromones.
Collision.
If there is something
pulls
to change the movement of the arm, did you protect by such a collision?
Yes.
Something from pheromone.
Sorry, I.
So your arm moves according to some software.
Yeah.
And did you foresee that something goes wrong and something 例如是。